of St. Clare. Before we begin our Mass today, let us take a moment to place ourselves in the presence of God as we observe a moment of silence. Stand and join us as we sing our opening song. Our opening song today is Christ Be Our Light.
Let us join now in confessing our sin. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through your word reconciled the human race to yourself in a wonderful way, grant, we pray, that with proper devotion and eager faith, Christian people may hasten toward the solemn celebrations to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Until the anger of the Lord against his people was so inflamed.
Their enemies burnt the house of God, tore down the walls of Jerusalem, set all its palaces afire, and destroyed all its precious objects. Those who escaped the sword were carried captive to Babylon, where they became servants of the king of the Chaldeans and his sons, until the kingdom of the Persians came to power. All this was to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah. Until the land has retrieved its lost Sabbaths, during all the time it lies waste, it shall have rest, while 70 years are fulfilled. In the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, in order to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah, the Lord inspired King Cyrus of Persia to issue his proclamation throughout his kingdom, both by word of mouth and in writing. Thus says Cyrus, king of Persia, all the kingdoms of the earth the Lord, the God of heaven, has given to me, and he has also charged me to build him a house in Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Whoever therefore among you belongs to any part of his people, let him go up, and may his God be with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, God, who is rich in mercy, because of the great love he has for us, Even when we were dead in our transgressions, he brought us to life with Christ. By grace you have been saved. He raised us up with him and seated us with him in the heavens in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from you. It is the gift of God. It is not from works, so no one may boast. For we are his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus for the good works that God has prepared in advance, that we should live in them. The word of the Lord.
Jesus said to Nicodemus, "Just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the verdict, that the light came into the world, but people preferred darkness to light, because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come toward the light, and his works might not be exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Hospitals and nursing homes opening to visitors, really is hope for all who have experienced isolation and separation for the past year. So many feel hopeful again and spirits are lifted by some simple and by some extraordinary changes. God cares. God saves. Jesus comes as Savior, and Jesus comes as light. That's the message of God's word today. In our first reading, we hear of Israel living in a foreign land as captives. Israel had turned away from God and covenant, and they were defeated. But the word we hear today is that God cares. God will return this nation to their own land. Cyrus, a foreign king, will make this possible. The people that felt lost and abandoned cried out to God, and God heard their cry. Paul tells us in his letter that we were dead and have been brought to life with Christ. By grace we have been saved through Christ and through faith. And John's Gospel tells us that God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. Light has come into the world. That's the faith that you and I celebrate, a faith that assures us that God cares and wants us to believe and to trust. We are given the promise of eternal life if we remain faithful. But God's word today reassures us that God cares about our life in the here and in the now, in the today. God cares about the situations that we face everyday life. But sometimes it's hard for us to recognize that. Sometimes when we come to pray, we try our best to put aside what we've been thinking about or what we've been worrying about. When we come to pray, we try to put aside our anger or our resentment over what someone has said or what someone has done. We try hard to put aside our grief and our pain and our loss, and even our anger with God, and we try to focus on prayer. We try to step out of our discouragement over some habit or addiction. And we do all of this so that we can focus on prayer. Israel called out to God from a place of exile. Nicodemus came to Jesus at night for fear that someone might see him talking with Jesus. God does not save us just at the end of our lives. Jesus makes it clear that he has come to be a light for the here and now. Sometimes the things that we try to put aside or the things that we really would rather not think about are the very things that we ought to be bringing to the Lord. It's in times of darkness that we need light, in times of pain that we need help. And that darkness, as we know, can take many different forms in our lives. And so we try to present ourselves to the Lord in our need. At the very least, we can realize in prayer that we are not alone. God is with us. God hears us. God knows our need. Sometimes God may use someone else to reach out and to help us, just as God uses Cyrus to reach out to the Israelites and to return them to their homeland. Sometimes it's just that sense of peace that we find in prayer that enables us to move on. Today, we will celebrate the Eucharist. We will come to receive the body and the blood of Christ. This is my body given for you. This is my blood poured out for you. I can't think of a better reminder or sign that God desires to be with us, to be the light in our darkness. Jesus comes to us wherever we are, right here and right now in our lives. right now in professing our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed now in our confidence, our faith and trust in God's mercy and God's care for us, let us come before the Lord in our need and in our prayer.
Our response today is, crucify the Lord, hear us. For the Church, may she be a beacon of light and hope to the world, we pray to the Lord.
Crucify the Lord, hear us.
For all the faithful, may the work they do this Lent season promote the mission of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Crucify the Lord, hear us.
For the unborn, the elderly, and those on death row, as all have a right to the sanctity of life, we pray to the Lord.
Crucify the Lord, hear us.
For doctors, nurses, and all first responders, as they dedicate their lives to caring for the sick and those most at risk in society, may they find comfort and inspiration in Christ the Healer. We pray to the Lord.
Crucify the Lord, hear us.
For those preparing for the Easter sacraments, may they know the joy of an authentic relationship with Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Crucify the Lord, hear us.
We pray for the sick, especially the terminally ill. May they pass peacefully from death to a new life in Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Crucify the Lord, hear us.
And for those who have died, may they share in the resurrected glory of our Lord. Especially for Richard Quaglieri, who died this past week, and for Michael Duran, L. Metcalf Jr., Jerome Buff, and Linda Richards, whom we remember in this liturgy, we pray to the Lord.
Crucify the Lord, hear us.
Loving and gracious God, we offer praise and thanks for the many gifts that you have shared with us. We come to you and ask you to be our light in our times of darkness, our joy in times of sorrow. We make our prayers always through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand and pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
We place before you with joy these offerings, which bring eternal remedy, O Lord, praying that we may both faithfully revere them and present them to you as is fitting, for the salvation of all the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus our Lord. By the mystery of the Incarnation, he has led the human race that walked in darkness into the radiance of the faith, and has brought those born in slavery to ancient sin through the waters of regeneration to make them your adopted children. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out without end, acclaim, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Look, we pray, upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Clare, St. Francis, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, Howard, our Bishop Emeritus, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed sisters and brothers, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. With him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us share with one another some sign of God's peace.
Should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my
attendance and door screeners for both Masses on Easter Sunday. We will be giving assigned seats, and both Masses, there's about 75 people right now at this time signed up, so we really do need to have seat attendance and door screeners. Please consider this. We'll train you how to do it. It's not hard. We just need people to be here on Easter Sunday morning. Mary Nicholson is looking for someone to chair the virtual crop walk this May. Please see the bulletin for details. And on Friday, March the 19th at 7 p.m., Anthony and Abby will have a virtual prayer service, and there's an insert in our bulletin for that. It is with sadness and a little joy that I announce that I put in my papers for retirement, effective June 1st. I say sadness because you guys are family to me. We have been together almost every weekend for the past 18 years. You have supported me in this ministry, and you've taught me so very much, and you've forgiven me when I've messed up. I say joy because, well, both of my parents and my husband were not able to retire. They died before retirement age. So I get to retire, and I think that's a good thing. I'll be able to spend more time with my sons and my grandson and do just about whatever I want. Who knows, I might even learn to cook. I don't want you to worry about the parish. I have an excellent staff and two great trustees. They are smart and committed to the parish, and I know that they will keep things running smoothly until and give the bishop time to figure out the leadership. My last day will be Sunday, May the 30th, which is Memorial Day weekend. I want to thank you for everything that you have done for me and for walking with me on this journey of faith. Please know that you will always be in my heart and in my prayers. Thank you.
O God, who enlighten everyone who comes into this world, illuminate our hearts, we pray, with the splendor of your grace, that we may always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and love you in all sincerity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Look upon those who call to you, O Lord, and sustain the weak. Give life by your unfailing light to those who walk in the shadow of death. And bring those rescued by your mercy from every evil to reach the highest good, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration here is ended. Let us go forth to continue to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.